Okay, good morning, guys. How are you?
Fine, teacher. How are you?
I'm fine, teacher. How are you?
Hello, everybody.
I'm fine, thank you. Okay, guys, everyone, open your cameras, please. Please open your camera, Gonzalo, Juan Camilo, Cindy y María Paula, por favor. Ok. Mientras esperamos que las compañeras abran la cámara, Juan Camilo, ¿tú viste la sesión pasada?
No, teacher.
Juan Camilo, no. Te recomiendo mucho que veas esa sesión, ¿de acuerdo?
Okay.
Pero por si algo te adelanto, una cosita, ya tus compañeros saben, pero tú no, y es que en Semana Santa vamos a tener clase común y corriente, ¿de acuerdo?
Ah, ok, teacher.
Ok, dale, martes y jueves a la misma hora, ¿ok?
Uh-huh.
Para mí es un gusto tenerlos a los cuatro, de verdad que sí, me alegra muchísimo. Poder realizar esta clase con ustedes y la clase de hoy va a tratar acerca de Vocabulary Focus y vamos a dar como una repasada muy juiciosa en las palabras compuestas, ¿sí? Para esto vamos a utilizar lecturas, vamos también a utilizar el Frayer Model, que ya lo habíamos trabajado, chicos, los que se acuerdan, en alguna clase. Bueno, vamos a empezar con preguntas generales. Gonzalo. Okay, wait a minute. Please, Cindy, Juan Camilo y María Paula, close your microphone. Gonzalo, do you know that they are composite words?
Composite words. For example, in Spanish I know, but in English I.
In English is the same.
Yes, but I don't remember in this moment an example. Farewell. Farewell.
Okay. Please explain that in Spanish for us.
Lo que acabo de decir es, bueno, que no recuerdo exacto en español, bueno, lo tengo claro, pero en inglés pues no se me venía a la mente un ejemplo rápido. Pronuncié fue farewell, que significa despedida.
Eso es una palabra compuesta para ti.
Supongo. I think so.
No problem, no problem. That's okay. Thank you very much, Gonzalo. Close your microphone. María Paula, open your microphone. María Paula, do you know that they are composite words? María. What is going on with María? María, are you here? María, I can hear you. Okay. I'm going to wait for María. And Cindy, open your microphone, please. Cindy, do you know that they are composite words? Cindy, I can hear you.
Can you hear me now?
You can hear Cindy?
Can you hear me
I can hear Cindy, but far, far away.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
María Paula, no, I can't hear María Paula.
Okay.
Oh. Maybe it's for the weather in Villavicencio in the morning. It was raining all the morning.
Yeah, está lloviendo en Villavo.
Yes.
María Paula lives in Santander, I think.
Pues que se quite los auriculares si la señal está muy mala y que lo intente así normal porque de pronto es eso, las diademas o los auriculares.
María Paula, pero parece que ella no nos puede escuchar.
The weather affects.
Cindy. María Paula, nobody's listening. Can you hear me, María? Please speak louder for me because I didn't hear you. Oh.
De pronto. Ojo no.
Quítate los audífonos de pronto. Oh my goodness. Okay. No, pero acá está todo bien. Gonzalo, close your microphone, please. Thank you. María, can you hear me? But I can hear you. Okay, voy a darles un consejo a ellas dos, porque me pasó ayer en la clase también que mi audio se fue. Salgan, no sé, reinicien el equipo o algo y vuelvan a entrar a la llamada, ¿listo? Porque creo que así no les va a dar. Okay. Juan Camilo, open your microphone, dear.
Yes.
Do you know that they are composite words?
The composite words are two words that come together to form a single word with its own meaning. For example, housewife in Spanish, man, ama de casa.
Okay, yeah. It's a very good example. Thank you very much.
Thanks.
Close your microphone.
You?
Cindy, I can hear you, but please speak louder, okay?
Okay. For example, outdoor.
Cindy, I can hear you. Sorry. What's the problem? What is going on? Is Brooke? Oh man. In the computer microphone? Or maybe the headphones of the phone? Oh man. Well, oh my gosh. Or close your camera and try to speak, maybe. Okay.
Teacher, I have a question. The session class is not for WhatsApp webcam. ¿No se puede hacer la clase por WhatsApp webcam?
No, dear, I'm sorry.
Ah, okay.
It is not possible. Sorry. Oh, wow. What is this noise? Maria Paula, can you hear me?
Yes, teacher, can you hear me now?
Yeah, I can hear you now. Maria Paula, tell me, do you know that they are composite words?
No, actually no. Even in Spanish, I don't know.
Okay,
or in Spanish. Maybe I think it's a word that is combined with another and both mean something different.
Okay. Please explain that in Spanish for us.
Yo no sé qué es eso, pero ni siquiera en español, pero creo que debe ser como una palabra que combinada con otra significan algo diferente.
Okay. Yeah, can be. I'm going to show you some examples in Spanish regarding composite words, okay? And you're going to have a better idea regarding that, okay? Okay, please wait a minute. ¿Pueden ver mi pantalla? Guys.
Yes, yes. Sí, teacher.
Okay. We're going to wait for a picture. Can you see?
Yes.
I can see here, yeah.
Okay. Gonzalo, come here.
Yes.
Please read this in Spanish, obviously.
Compound words. Son palabras que se forman con la unión de dos palabras simples. Examples, sacapuntas, sharpener, girasol, espantapájaros, cortaúñas. Y paraguas.
Yeah, this is a good example. See the next example. Please, Juan Camilo, come here.
Okay, teacher. Abre latas, abre cartas, aeropuerto, astronauta, automóvil, coliflor, pelirrojo y telaraña.
Okay. Esta es la parte compuesta. Abre, bueno, esta es la parte compuesta de la oración, cartas, ¿ok? Eso es para que ustedes tengan una idea general de lo que son las palabras compuestas como tal. ¿Me hago entender?
Yes, teacher.
Yes, teacher. Okay.
Entonces, now, por what is a composite word? Now,
the signal is bad sometimes. The signal is bad. I can hear you very well sometimes.
Oh, sorry. Can you hear me now?
Yes, yes. Now it's clear.
For you, now, what is a composite word? Now,
the two words are united. Yes, unidas. For example, sunflower, housewife. Like the example, our partner Juan Camilo, housewife or housewives in plural. Fireman, fireman is another example, or firemen, firefighters is another example. Yeah. It's the only one of two words, simple words, like a red.
Thank you very much. Close your microphone. Okay. Maria Paula. Come here, please. Now, for you, what is a composite word?
I think it's the same that I just said. Are two words that both when you, I don't remember, cuando uno las une, significan algo diferente a lo que significan separar.
Thank you very much, María Paula González. Sorry, Juan Camilo, come here.
Yes, teacher.
What is for you? Yeah, composite word.
A composite word is two words. That may something, for example, full moon.
Oh.
Or sunflower.
Okay, thank you very much. Thank you very much, guys. I'm going to close this. Wait a minute, please. Okay, guys. Somebody knows about Cindy. Where is Cindy? Nobody knows.
Está reiniciando el computador y todo eso.
Okay. Well, do you remember the Freyer model? Somebody remember the Freyer model? Nobody? Sorry?
El cuadrito que hicimos el otro día con las características y el significado y eso.
Yeah.
Definition, example.
The chart, yeah. I'm going to give you the chart again, and I'm going to give you one word, okay? And we're going to resolve the exercise, all right?
Right.
Wait a minute. Grow, can you see the Freyer model?
Yes, teacher.
Yes. Okay. So, van a copiar este Freyer model en una hoja, como lo hicimos la clase anterior. Lo van a copiar exactamente. Y les voy a dar una palabra a todos. Es la misma palabra que les voy a dar, pero cada uno lo va a resolver de forma individual. ¿De acuerdo? Les voy a dar la palabra everywhere. Are you understand?
Everywhere.
Are you understand, Gonzalo?
Everywhere de en cualquier parte o ca.
Yes. This is the word.
Yes, everywhere.
María Paula, are you understand?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, I'm going to give you 10 minutes to solve the exercise, okay? Remember that this activity is an individual activity, okay? And you're going to explain that in 10 or 12 minutes, right? Are you understand, guys?
Yes, teacher, I understand.
Okay, I'm going to see you in a 10 or 12 minutes, okay?
La palabra es everywhere, ¿cierto?
Sí, madre.
Sí, Paula.
Everywhere.
Listo, gracias.
Guys, are you ready?
No, teacher, more time, please.
Okay, I'm going to give you 2 minutes more. Guys, time is over right now. Please open your cameras. Juan Camilo, open your camera, please. And Maria Paula, please open your camera. And Gonzalo, please show me your Freyer model. I can see. Okay, very well. Please explain your Freyer.
Okay, the word is everywhere. A definition is, for example, in all places, yes, or it is the whole of a place. Is another definition that I found on the internet. Characteristics. Is for me, it was difficult to write about it. Everywhere. So I wrote omnidirectional and omnipresent. Examples, his children go everywhere with him. It's an example in English. And I looked everywhere for my keys. I wrote 2 examples. And non-example is anywhere, Antonisa. And nowhere is another to say that word in English, nowhere.
Okay.
Yes.
Please close your microphone and Juan Camilo, close your microphone. Maria Paula, show me your Freyer model, please. Nice. Please open your microphone and explain it out.
The word is everywhere. My definition is everywhere is means in all places or in every place. Characteristics is a compound word, every and where, and is a indefinite pronoun that refers to a place. For example, I was walking everywhere looking for this dress, or I really think that God is in everywhere. And not examples, something that you can find in a specific place or a specific place for do something special.
Okay, that's all?
Yes.
Close your microphone, dear. Juan Camilo, okay. Open your microphone and show me your Freyer model.
Okay, everywhere for me it's in every place or part or in all places is my definition. Examples, every way I go they pull me, if no I said every way, you know, or every way, everywhere in the world. Characteristics to every place or and in every place. An example is anywhere or examples with anywhere or examples with everywhere is I'm everywhere. It's an incorrect form or other. It's the part is everywhere. It's an incorrect part.
Okay. Thank you very much. Close your microphone.
You're welcome.
Okay, chicos. Las palabras compuestas como tal las podemos encontrar en cualquier lugar. Muchas veces al hacer lecturas las encontramos, las damos por hecho. Y no las analizamos muy bien, ¿no? Porque ya las damos por hecho mentalmente. Lo que yo busco en estas sesiones, por si no lo han notado, es que estudiemos lo irrelevante de lo relevante, ¿de acuerdo? Entonces eso sería algo irrelevante a nuestro parecer, pero cuando lo vemos bien es relevante, dándole sentido a lo que decimos o a lo que leemos, ¿ok? Well, guys, now I'm going to give you a compound word, okay? And you're going to write in a Freyer model again, writing the compound word, okay? And you're going to explain it out, right? Okay, are you understand, guys?
Yes, for sure.
Okay. Maria Paula, your word, ice cream.
Okay. Okay. It's the same exercise, yeah?
Yeah, it's the same. Okay. What is it, Maria Paula? Sorry. You take a picture?
Yeah, but... Es que puse como el dedo para pelear y pues no hice otra cosa por allá.
Okay, no problem. Your word is ice cream, okay? Yeah. Gonzalo, your word is post office.
Okay, post office. Post office.
Juan Camilo, your word is full moon. Okay.
Okay.
Are you understand, guys?
Yes, teacher, I understand.
going to give you 5 minutes. Okay, just 5.
Okay.
Hey, Cindy, can you hear me?
Yeah.
Cindy, I can hear you now. But very, very, very slow, but I can hear you. Please, wait a minute. Oh, what is going on? Are you ready, guys? Guys, are you ready?
No, teacher.
Okay. I'm going to give you 2 minutes more.
Thank you very much.
Guys, time is over. Please open your cameras. Okay. Juan Camilo, are you here?
Yes, teacher. Ya terminé.
Open your camera and show me your flyer motto.
One moment, please.
Okay, no problem.
Okay. One moment.
Hello. Okay, nice. I like it. Please explain me your prayer.
Okay, my... antes de empezar, I have a question. No. Nothing.
Okay.
Es que me falta solo un tip que es no un example. No lo completo.
Juan Camilo, don't matter. Explain your prayer. Don't matter.
Okay. Entonces, full moon, my definition is the full moon when the full of its disk is illuminated, occurring when the opposition to the sun. Characteristics, the face of the moon at this time or the time of moon is seen. Examples, see the full moon is very beautiful, have you full moon in its year? No more.
Okay. That's very short, but I like it. Thank you very much, Juan Camilo. Close your microphone. Maria Paula, open your microphone and show me your prayer model.
Okay, teacher.
Oh, very nice. I like it. Very nice.
The word is ice cream. Ice cream is something that you can eat and is frozen. It's a frozen dessert. Characteristic, it's a dessert, it's frozen. There are different flavors and it can be frozen or creamy. An example, I love the berries ice cream. Not examples, something that is not frozen.
Yeah, very good. I like it. Thank you very much, Maria Paula. Thank Close you. Your microphone here. Gonzalo, the king, open your microphone. Okay. The student Please, come on. Show me your for your model. Okay. Okay, explain your prayer, please.
Post my word is post office. Definition is a place where stamps are sold and from where letters are sent. Okay. To someone. Characteristics, it is public, it is an organization. The example, Chico let her pension from the post office, or her word is to send a stamp from the post office, okay? And on examples, I didn't write any word about it, non example. In Spanish, what is the meaning of non-example?
Non-example regarding post office?
Yes. My understanding about non-example is antonism. I don't know how.
Non-example and simple example is a car office. This is another example of POTS office.
You said for an example, what?
Car office?
So non-example in Spanish, what is the meaning of non-example in Spanish?
Okay, por ejemplo, oficina de carros o sí, supermercado. Eso,
pero ¿cuál es el significado de non-example en español?
Significado es que no tiene relación alguna, si me entiendes, como lo que no es un ejemplo de la oficina de carreras. Are you understand?
Yes. I think that is an antonism. In the past activity, I said antonism about it. Okay. Mm-hmm.
I can see, Gonzalo, but thank you very much, okay?
Okay.
Close your microphone, very well. Okay. Chicos, vamos a retomar la palabra everywhere, okay? Entonces la vamos a dividir en every, sorry for the noise, is my neighbor, okay? Vamos a dividir la palabra every y were, ¿ok? Everywhere es una palabra compuesta, pero la vamos a dividir. Entonces, vamos a crear frases u oraciones con cada parte de la palabra. Por ejemplo, con every day, ese puede ser un ejemplo. Con where, podemos hacer una pregunta, where are you? ¿Sí? Entonces ahí está la división de la palabra y en lo que se puede utilizar cada parte, ¿de acuerdo? Entonces, María Paula, te voy a asignar la palabra every y tú vas a crear dos oraciones o dos frases, ¿de acuerdo? Gonzalo, te voy a asignar la palabra where. Vas a crear dos oraciones, dos preguntas con esa frase, ¿de acuerdo? Juan Camilo, te asignó la palabra every. Vas a crear dos oraciones, okay, de acuerdo a ello. Okay, I'm going to give you just 3 minutes, I think that. Okay?
I finish now, teacher, it's very fast.
Did you finish? Okay,
come on. Where are you from? Where do you live? The signal is bad.
Are you finished, right?
We have to write in my case. We have to write. I have to write two questions.
Or examples.
Yeah. Where are you from? Where do you live?
Where are you live?
¿Dónde vives? Where do you live?
Where do you live is the right question. Okay. Where do you live? Okay. Are you understand?
Where do you live? No.
Yeah, it's the right. It's not where are you live.
No, I said where do you live.
Are you sure?
La señal está molestando. Se va, se viene.
Okay, sorry for my bad signal, I think. Okay, Gonzalo, thank you very much.
Okay.
Close your microphone. Maria Paula, are you ready?
Yes, teacher.
Please give me your examples or phrases.
The first one is a phrase of a song. It's a little part of a song. It says, I fall in love with you every single day. And the other one is everything that I do for my mom is with love.
I like it. Very creative. Thank you very much.
Okay.
Juan Camilo. Sorry, I'm screaming. Juan Camilo, come here.
Yes, I'm finished.
Okay. Give your phrases or examples.
Okay. First, I'm going to the basketball court every day.
Yeah. And the second one?
This is it's un poco exagerado. My parents call me every second.
Okay, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Well, guys, we're going to make another exercise with a Freire model, but this exercise in a group. It's in a group, okay? Bueno, muchachos, les voy a colocar ya como último ejercicio nuevamente el Freire Model, pero lo van a desarrollar en grupo. Lo van a desarrollar ustedes tres. Ustedes tres van a asignar la palabra. No les voy a dar la palabra. Sencillamente van a asignar una palabra compuesta y la van a desarrollar en el Freire Model, ¿ok? ¿Sí? Are you understand?
Yes.
Yes, sure. Yes, sure.
Voy a colocar la imagen del Freire Model, por si alguna cosa, la voy a colocar en pantalla. Ay, disculpen.
¿Qué palabra vamos a elegir? ¿Son flowers?
Chicos, qué pena, voy a hacer un paréntesis, está lloviendo, entonces de pronto puede haber un poco de mala señal, les pido una disculpa, ¿ok?
No problema, chicos.
Ok. This is the Freire model. I'm going to give you 10 minutes. Can you see the Freire?
No.
Ok, let's... Wait a minute, please. Oh, man. Okay, guys, I don't know what is going on, but please create your own Freire model, okay? Speak about it in a group.
Okay, so we're going to... What is the word? We're going to choose a word.
Old wife.
Okay,
old wife.
This is an easy sample to...
Which is the word? I can't understand.
Oh, Maria Paula, can choose? You choose the word. Yeah?
Repeat. Hola.
Maybe, I don't know if that word could be, but I think Superman.
Okay, yes. Superman.
That's a good example.
Yeah. So, definition of Superman is a superhero, ¿no?
Yes,
Superman.
Ay, madre. Yeah, this is a main logic.
Characteristics strong.
It's a hero from the DC.
¿Cómo?
Es un superhéroe de DC, del universo DC, o sea, la empresa. Ya volviéndolo, digamos, a lo legal.
Marvel, Avengers Endgame, Juan Camilo, where are you, man? Where is your mind?
Me gusta ver, o sea, más que puedo leerlo.
yes.
Another characteristic.
Ah, bueno. Digamos, en cuanto a eso sería así, pero digamos, rayos láser, stronger, very stronger.
Yes.
Super fat.
And he can fly.
Sí.
Okay. An example.
Examples. It is Superman, so he can fly. He flies to save people.
For example, not it's a beer, not it's a plane, it's a Superman.
Superman is the
I think an example is Superman is a superhero like Batman.
Yes.
Yeah, it's a couple.
The signal is bad. I can hear you.
And non-example. We can refer about, I don't know the word, a villano, un villano de una película.
Yes, villain.
El guasón.
Sí.
Se va el sonido.
Yeah. Ya está, listo.
Okay, entonces quién dice la definición o las características?
The word is Superman, ¿no? Superhero.
Sí, ya.
Yeah.
Superhero.
Another definition is maybe a man with superpowers, ¿no?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, that's it.
Are you ready, guys?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, wait a minute, please. Okay, show me your prayer and explain me that, please.
Okay.
Okay. Explain me that.
The word is Superman. It's a compound word because it's super and man. Definition is Superman is a superhero. It's a man with a superpowers.
Okay.
Next.
Characteristics. He is strong. Yes. Uh-huh. He in this case he flies.
Yeah.
Yes, and he uses an uniform like the other superheroes. That's it.
The other example can be he comes from Krypton, right?
Oh, me iba a decir, yes. Pero ah.
Krypton, planet, Krypton planet.
Sí, ya.
He
hasn't
like
Kryptonite. Okay, tell me more about it, about him.
Examples, not disappear, not explain, it's Superman.
Okay, guys, you're very creative, really creative.
Okay, non-example, he's a super villain.
Okay, guys, thank you very much. Our season is over right now, and I want to ask you some questions, okay?
Okay, teacher.
What did you learn regarding compound words, Gonzalo?
Okay, today the topic is composite words. It is a noun. It was a noun topic today, yes? At the beginning, I forgot it, but it is an easy and a noun topic, composite word, yes?
Thank you,
Bruce.
Sorry.
No, don't worry. And the other, I like to do this activity. The Freyer model is a good activity to. It's similar. I remember the past activities what I did in the past. For example, estaba. I don't know. I remember that past activities when I played in the past. Okay.
Okay, thank you very much, Gonzalo. Maria Paula, what did you learn regarding compound words?
At the beginning, I think about compound words, and I know it, but I didn't was sure. But then we learn about the meaning of compound words, and now I know, and I'm sure that what is that.
Okay. Thank you, Maria Paula. Juan Camilo, what do you learn regarding compound words?
I learn compound words about these very important because that's the man, for example, house or wife. It's separate, is very different, or when it is same. House, wife, man, ama de casa. So I learn about to the compost world your difference when is separate are the unit. Cuando están separadas a cuando están unidas.
Okay. Thank you very much. Well, guys, I'm going to give you some general things, okay? I'm going to say for everyone some things regarding the work about today. Okay? And the first one is María Paula. María Paula, buen desarrollo de la actividad, muy creativa tú. Cada vez que me dabas un ejemplo, me mostrabas alguna cosa, me dejabas impresionada de la creatividad. Te defiendes buen nivel, como siempre recomiendo práctica y muchas correcciones de acuerdo a gramática oral. De acuerdo, pero en términos generales te fue muy bien. Gonzalo, okay. Buen desarrollo de la actividad. You're welcome. Buen desarrollo de la actividad, Gonzalo. Siempre te estaré recomendando gramática oral y pronunciación, por favor. Que bueno, obviamente eso es con la práctica y demás, pero sí te recomiendo que lo tengas muy, muy en cuenta y conexión de palabras también, ¿vale? Pero en términos generales, buen desarrollo de la actividad, te felicito mucho. Juan Camilo, respecto a esa actividad también, buen desarrollo de la actividad, buena disposición. Sigo recomendando gramática oral y pues mucha práctica y también conexiones entre oraciones y palabras, ¿de acuerdo?
Ok, teacher.
Ok, guys. Bueno, por esta semana ya no nos vemos más, nos vemos Dios mediante la próxima semana, como ya les había dicho, martes y jueves a la misma hora. Y bueno, muchachos, no hay ninguna actividad. Algo que yo quiero preguntar, sí, es si ustedes recibieron la encuesta respecto a los encuentros de Speak, ¿sí? ¿Sí la recibieron? Sí, sí. ¿Ya la desarrollaron?
Sí, yo ya la envié, sí, señora.
Ok. Desarróllenla, muchachos. Esto no viene directamente a mí. No voy a saber yo nada de esto en absoluto. Quienes van a saber de nuestro desarrollo como practicantes son nuestros tutores encargados del área de Pedagogical Experience 2. Entonces, no se preocupen que no me voy a enterar, pero sí, por favor, desarrollen la que es importante para nosotros, ¿ok? Ok, chicos. Tía. Sonrían, por favor, sonrían. Les fue bien, no perdieron. Ok, guys, see you in the next week. Thank you very much.
Okay, see you.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.